Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in this video, we will learn how the MOSFET can be used as an amplifier with the active load. So first of all, we will understand what is active load and why it is commonly used in the amplifier circuit. And during our discussion, we will mostly focus on the common source amplifier. So this active load is commonly used in the integrated circuits, where the size and the power consumption both are major constraints. Making a resistor in the ICs requires a lot of space. So instead of that, an active component like a MOSFET or the MOSFET circuit is used instead of the resistor. So this active component or the active circuit which is used instead of this resistor is known as the active load. And this active load also has certain advantages. For example, if we take the simple common source amplifier circuit, then its gain is equal to minus gm times rd. And here, for a moment, we have neglected the effect of the channel length modulation. That means we have assumed that the output resistance of this MOSFET is equal to infinite. Now here, if we want to increase this gain, then there are two ways. Either we need to increase the value of this rd, or we need to increase the transconductance. So the value of rd cannot be increased indefinitely, because as the value of RD increases, then the voltage drop across this resistor will also increase. And because of that, the available voltage at this drain terminal will reduce. And if we keep on increasing the value of RD, then at one point, the MOSFET may come out of the saturation. So there is a limitation on the value of the RD. And when we are talking about the ICs, then anyway, using a large value of resistor is not a viable option. But even in the discrete MOSFET circuits also, the resistor RD cannot be increased indefinitely. Now the second option is to increase the value of this transconductance. Now if you are aware, then this transconductance GM can be given as 2 times ID divided by VGS minus VT, that is the overdrive voltage. So to increase the transconductance, we can increase this drain current. But as we increase the drain current, then the power dissipation in the circuit will also increase. And particularly in the ICs, we have a limited power budgeting. Moreover, as we increase the value of this ID, then the voltage drop across this resistor RD will also increase. And because of that, the available voltage at the drain terminal will reduce. On the other hand, what we can do, we can keep the value of ID as it is, and we can increase the value of the W by L, because this transconductance GM can also be given as square root of 2 times ID mu n times Cox times W divided by L. So by keeping the same value of ID, we can increase the value of W by L. But as we increase the value of W by L, then the area which is required to make this MOSFET will also increase. And in that case, this MOSFET will require a more space in the IC. That means we cannot increase the value of RD as well as this GM indefinitely. Of course, by increasing the power supply voltage, we can increase the gain by some extent. But that is not the case in the ICs, where a power supply voltage is shrinking day by day. But this problem can be overcome if we replace the resistor by the current source. And for a moment, let us assume that this current source is the ideal current source. So here, this current source will act as an active load. Now if this current source is an ideal current source, then there are two advantages. One is, the biasing current of this circuit will be independent of the temperature as well as the device parameters of the MOSFET. And the second is, during the small signal analysis, this ideal current source can be replaced by the open circuit. And if the output resistance of this MOSFET is infinite, then ideally the gain of this amplifier will be infinite. But as we all know, the MOSFET has the finite output resistance, and because of that, the gain will be also finite. That means if you see the small signal equivalent circuit, then it can be represented like this, where this R0 is the output resistance of this MOSFET. And in this case, if we see the gain, then this gain can be given as minus GM times R0. So clearly, there is a significant improvement in the gain. And in fact, this gain is known as the intrinsic gain. So this intrinsic gain is the maximum obtainable gain for this common source amplifier. But we can obtain this gain if the current source is the ideal current source. But if you see the actual current source, then the current source has the finite output resistance. And hence, in the small signal equivalent circuit, it can be replaced by its output resistance. So with the finite output resistance of this current source, if you see the small signal equivalent circuit, then it will look like this. So here, this R02 is the output resistance of this current source, while this R01 is the output resistance of this MOSFET. So in this case, if we see the voltage gain, then this voltage gain is equal to minus GM times R01 in parallel with R02. So clearly, due to the finite output resistance of this current source, the voltage gain will be less than the intrinsic voltage gain. But still, this voltage gain will be greater than the voltage gain which is obtained with the drain resistor. Alright, so now the question is, how to make this current source using the MOSFET? Well, if you are aware, then in the saturation region, the MOSFET can be used as a current source. Because in the saturation region, this drain current ID is a function of VGS. And this drain current ID can be given as K times VGS minus VT whole square, where this K is the device parameters. And if you see the exact equation, then it will be equal to half times mu n times COX times W by L times VGS minus VT whole square. So for the fixed value of the voltage VGS, this drain current ID will remain constant. And in that case, the MOSFET can be used as a constant current source. So when we want to connect a current source between the supply and some node in the circuit, then we can use the P-type MOSFET. So here, as you can see, the source terminal is connected to the VDD, while the fixed gate voltage can be applied at the gate terminal. And in this way, this voltage VGS can be kept fixed. And at the drain terminal, the remaining circuit can be connected. So as far as this bias voltage is kept fixed, then the VGS will remain fixed. And in this way, this circuit can be used as a current source. Of course, here to ensure the operation of the MOSFET in the saturation region, the voltage at the drain terminal should be such that this VSD is greater than or equal to VSD minus VT. Similarly, when we want to connect a current source between some node in the circuit to the ground, then we can use the NMOS as a current source. So in this case, as you can see, the source terminal of the MOSFET is connected to the ground and a fixed gate voltage is applied at the gate terminal. So with the fixed gate to source voltage, the MOSFET can be used as a constant current source. And of course, here to operate the MOSFET in the saturation region, the condition, that is VDS, should be greater than or equal to VGS minus VT should get fulfilled. But anyway, in our case, we need to replace this current source by the P-type MOSFET. So now, using the small signal analysis, let us find the voltage gain of this given circuit. So for the small signal analysis, all the DC sources in the circuit will act as a zero. And for this PMOS, if you see the small signal model, then here, the gate and the source terminal both are connected to the ground terminal. That means this voltage VGS will be equal to zero. And since this voltage VGS is equal to zero, then this dependent current source will also act as a open circuit. That means from the drain side, if you see the equivalent resistance, then it is equal to R0. That means in the equivalent circuit, we can replace this PMOS by its output resistance. And if you see the small signal equivalent circuit, then it will look like this. And in this case, the voltage gain can be given as minus GM times R01 in parallel with R02, where this R02 is the output resistance of this PMOS, while the R01 is the output resistance of this MOSFET. So in this way, the PMOS can be used as a current source or active load in the common source amplifier. So here, because of the finite output resistance of this PMOS, this voltage gain is always less than the intrinsic gain. And suppose if this R01 is equal to R02, then in that case, this voltage gain will be half of the intrinsic gain. So typically, in the current integrated circuits, the achievable intrinsic gain is in the range of 20 to 50. But with the finite output resistance of this current source, the voltage gain will further reduce. So to achieve the higher gain, the output resistance of this current source should be increased. And that can be increased if we use the cascode current source. So by using the cascode current source along with the cascode amplifier, it is possible to improve the voltage gain. So in the upcoming videos, we will learn about this cascode amplifier as well as the cascode current source. Moreover, whenever we use a single PMOS or the NMOS device as a current source, then we still have an issue of the biasing stability. Because in this case, the device parameters like this mobility and the threshold voltage are a function of the temperature. That means with the temperature, these parameters will change, and because of that, this drain current or the biasing current will also change. Moreover, if this biasing voltage is not stable, then the voltage VGS will change. And because of that, this drain current or the biasing current will get affected. So to make a more robust biasing, typically a current mirror circuit is used as a current source. And particularly in the ICs, this current mirror circuit is used as an active load. So in the subsequent videos, we will learn about this current mirror circuit as well as the cascode amplifiers. But I hope in this video, you understood the concept of the active load and its basic need in the amplifier circuit. So if you have any question or suggestion, then do let me know here in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.